Bluetooth on the Advent OCH1 incorporates the latest Parrot chipset, which allows this thing to be very fast. It's got a ton of features. It'll accept a ton of devices and super easy to use. And honestly, it is one of, if not the best sounding Bluetooth systems that we currently sell in any nav that we sell, honestly. It is just, so far as we can tell, it's pretty flawless, and it works with just about every phone we've ever tried to pair to it. So to access that, we can hit our Bluetooth button, and it'll bring up our main Bluetooth menu, where you see we've got a touchpad for dialing, we've got device, we've got transfer. We turn our Bluetooth on and off on this screen as well. And if we go into our device screen, you can see that it's got open spots for five devices there on the main page, and we can do another five behind that. We hit our settings button, and that tells it whether or not we want it to automatically connect, and we can set our own PIN code. And to give you in real time an idea of exactly how this thing works, I'll go ahead and pair my phone, literally in real time. This is the first time I've tried to do it on this unit. We hit wireless and networks, we hit Bluetooth settings, scan for devices. Now, there we go. It came up with Advent. We'll pair with this device. It should come up with 1234 as our code. We hit OK. And it should go ahead and start our pairing process. And it'll take, it might take 30 seconds or so. And once it does bring up our device, it should ask whether or not we want it to push our phone book. There we go. We'll go ahead and it says it's requesting permission to connect to the phone book on this phone. Let's go ahead and hit accept. And now it's going to go ahead and start pushing our phone book to this to the Advent straight out of the phone, and it'll do that every time as long as we give the Advent access to the phone book built into the phone. So we can again choose our device. We see Walt's Incredible 2. If you have other phones, you could move to any phone that's currently paired with the unit just by hitting the device in the list. Now, some of the functions that are available from this screen, very obviously, are, again, our dial pad. We've got mic gain up and down to fine-tune the sound quality from our microphone. And in this case, the microphone is mounted right up above the rearview mirror, right dead center in the at the top of the windshield, up at the forward edge of the headliner. So it's about perfect spot for it. Over here, you can see we've got A2DP, and we've got a voice-activated dialing icon as well. Let's show you A2DP. So first off, A2DP is our audio playback from the phone. So if we go out here and we choose, let's say, for instance, iHeartRadio, we can go ahead and bring up our iHeartRadio app, and we can go ahead and push audio out of the phone into the Bluetooth or the Advent. So we can play, again, anything we want here. Let's say iHeartRadio. We want to go to California. Let's go to San Diego. Let's listen to 101 KGB. Now we can go ahead and turn our volume up. We're listening to Supertramp on iHeartRadio on KGB in San Diego. We're in Seattle, by the way, so very obviously iHeart gives us the ability to listen to stations all across the country. So we can do this not only with apps like iHeartRadio and Pandora, but we can also go ahead, if we chose to, play music that's contained on the phone itself. We can go ahead and stream it straight out of the phone, too. Okay, so we've got the ability to do music or audio via streaming Bluetooth audio very easily off of our phone. So very simple, very straightforward playback capable with A2DP. Now our voice activated dialing is probably what's going to be used most often. And that's as simple as hitting the button. Call messages.
Call messages on mobile.
Simple as that. We can access anything that's in the phone.
Can you reach Paul with the ADC mobile? Sorry, couldn't take your call.
We can reach anything that's in the phone. And of course, the phone has to be capable of voice recognition because it is accessing that function that's built into your current phone. Now, the contacts, while we've been going through all of the demonstration here, the contacts have been downloading, and now we can just go ahead and scroll right through them, or if we want to go and have direct access with any at any alphabetical letter there, we can go ahead and gain direct access to any of these. We can bring up, for instance, Ben Thompson. We hit the number, and if we wanted to dial that, we just hit the green button, and it'll go ahead and dial Ben just with that series of buttons, or a series of commands. We have our call logs that have our dialed calls, our received calls, our missed calls, etc. And then those have multiple levels of of every one of these lists. So they go back pretty extensively, and you're going to be able to call any one of these contacts just by hitting the number and dialing. So Bluetooth on the OCH1, quite frankly, blows away the factory and blows away most aftermarket Bluetooth sections of almost every nav that we sell. It's a great, great Bluetooth built into this. So that's it. That's the Bluetooth section on the Advent OCH1.